This video tutorial I will explain what happens when you type URL into your web browser. Here you can see the person called Peter who enters URL into the browser and hits on enter button. We will see what happens. Before that we will see what is URL. Here you can see the URL. URL stands for Universal Resource Locator. URL has four parts. The first part is scheme. In this example, the scheme is HTTP. This tells the browser to connect to the server using the protocol called HTTP. Another common scheme is HTTPS. With HTTPS, the connection between the browser and the web server is encrypted. Second part of the URL is a domain. In this case, the domain is romj2e.blackspot.com. It is the domain name of the site. Third part of the URL is the path. In this example, path is 2022/11. And the fourth part of the URL is resource. In this example, resource is nothing but top 15 wild animals names in English .html. And path and resources are similar to directory and file in the regular file system. They together specify the resource on the server we want to load. Peter enters URL into the browser and hits enter. Then browser looks up IP address in the hash. And if browser cannot find IP address in the hash, then browser looks up IP address using recursive DNS lookup, and it involves DNS resolver and DNS server. Once browser find IP address, browser establishes a TCP connection with the server. Then browser sends HTTP request to the server. Then server sends back HTTP response. Then browser renders HTTP content. And this is the flow. We will see each and every step in detail. Peter entered URL into the browser. What happened next? The browser needs to know how to reach the server. In this case, it is romj2e.blogspot.com. This is done with the process called DNS lookup. DNS stands for Domain Name System. Think of it as a phone book of the internet. DNS translates domain names to IP addresses, so browsers can load resources. Now to make the lookup process fast, the DNS information is heavily hashed. First, the browser itself hashes it for the short period of time. And if it is not in the browser hash, the browser asks the operating system for it. The operating system itself has a hash for it, which also keeps the answer for the short period of time. And if the operating system does not have it, it makes a query out to the internet, to the DNS resolver. This sets off a chain of requests until IP address is resolved. This is an elaborate and elegant process. Just to keep in mind that this process involves many servers in the DNS infrastructure. And the answer is hashed every step of the way. Now finally, the browser has the IP address of the server. Using the IP address, browser establishes TCP connection with the server. After that, handshake involved in establishing TCP connection. It takes several network round trips for this to complete. To keep the loading process fast, modern browsers use something called a keep alive connection to try to reuse an established TCP connection to the server as much as possible. If the protocol is HTTPS, the process of establishing a new connection is even more involved. It requires a complicated process called SSL-TLS handshake to establish the encrypted connection between the browser and the server. This handshake is expensive. Finally, the browser sends HTTP request to the server over the established TCP connection. The web server processes the request and sends back HTTP response. The browser receives the response and renders HTML content. Oftentimes, there are additional resources to load, like JavaScript bundles and images. The browser repeats the process that we mentioned above, like making DNS lookup, establishing TCP connection, making HTTP request to finish fetching all other resources. You can get Java source code link for each video from the description section of the video. And here you can see the video. And to see the description, click on this more. And here you can see the description. And here you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.